Right, back again. If you haven't watched part one, watch part one, folks. Just quickly to finish this hand up space cup. If you had three times a stack, or even a bit more than double your stack, then just raising there would have been okay. And if these guys had like he'd a double stack and he'd maybe a bit more, and he definitely, or if they were tight, but then with your stack size, even if they were the tightest guys in the book, you still can't take the chance that you're playing for your whole stack with Queen High. But if you had three times your stack, then that'd be a standard open probably 100% of the time. But because of your stack size, it's a standard fold or a standard shove, 50% of the time each, up to you. Depends how you feel. But if they're all tight boys on here, then okay, you can give it an easy shove. But I wouldn't be playing for that the way it was. Anyhow, not too bad, but as I say, it's a big thing to thought about. So we got it through, didn't we? In fact, we never even got that far, did we? I don't think we did get it through. See, that's why, and that's what I try and tell Rick. I know he hates it, but see that's called being exploitable. That's why you shove hands there, because that's non-exploitable. See, look there, you shove. If he can call you, you've still got, even if he's got ace king, I mean, you've still got 40% chance of winning the thing. But see, once you get below 15 or below, it's a rough area, but it's 17, whatever big binds below, you don't want to be raising and then folding to things like that in the flop. Actually, he's even got the wee thing there, he's a chancer. So that's why, and I don't think Rick understands that. He thinks I'm just playing overly aggressive, but the key thing is to be non-exploitable, and no one can exploit you if you've already got all your chips in. And hey, let's play for them. That's the big key thing to all that people just don't understand, or just they see it in the level before. They don't actually understand why it's actually, this is the what you do with 15 big blinds old thing. Because there, if you just open shipped it or folded it, then you would not be exploited. But well, you've seen what happens anyhow. I think I made my point there. But that's why there's things called shoving ranges, and it's all to be, it's non-exploitable poker. Bet you're raging now with that cunt. Fucking swearing at him and this, that, the other. I'll fucking get you. Right, nothing wrong with that, and we're going to suck out, aren't we? In fact, I wouldn't have played that any differently. I could have folded. Well, we are at that stage, so I don't think there's anything wrong. I don't know if I could have found a fold there. I possibly. No, I'd have probably shoved that space. I don't know how correct I would have been in. Because remember, we have got no fold equity, and we are always going to be never really that much ahead. And do you think a player would really be raising it to 600 when he knows that you're going to have to call? So I think that's maybe something to look out for. That if a player's in any way half decent, he's only raising that hoping to induce you to ship. He's trying to look as if he's on the steal, and it worked as well. But I don't think there's nothing wrong with the fold, but the shove. But I think it's something to look out for, that generally, unless they're really, really weak, sometimes they'd even fold to your thing, but they're not expecting a fold from you. So generally, it means something of strength when they're doing that. Where's the six? Where's the six? Huh? What happened there? My hands out of order. We did lose that, didn't we? And I just don't know what's going on anymore. kind of ruins the video, doesn't it? Let's go back to that one actually. That was Donkey Boy. I think this sounds mixed up with. Anyhow, we'll just play them for the thing. I don't know which one there. I don't mind the shove. I don't mind the shove. There, it's a fault. That's it. You got it. As I say, non-exploitable, because you'd end up, if you raised that and the flop came ace, king, queen, well, ace, king, and somebody just bet, then you'd have to fold your jacks. But hey, you've probably got the best hand as it stands, so let's just get them in. Don't just call, don't hang. Again, that's my bugbear with Rick. He's a thing to do that. Sorry, I'm supposed to not be mentioning Rick, but I wouldn't mind Rick actually knowing why. You know, I'm getting on at him about things. Well, I got a full C. There, Space Guy, I would actually, I'd have preferred one of your check raises there, to tell you the truth. I know it's a thing. You're actually getting not a bad stack again, aren't you? I'd have went for even to check call. The reason being is, see, when you bet that, there's not a lot of hands that are going to call. Well, okay, I've been proved wrong with that. I don't know. What would I have done there? Okay. It's a funny one. I'd have to sit and think, but I don't mind. We'll still see how we go. Oof. We can discuss this one more. I'd like to... I was going to say what hands are calling you, but you're against a mega donk, and I think there'll be a bit of frustrations come into your part there. Remember, the main thing being here, Space Cat, is it didn't actually cost you any money to play this hand, so I would not be going bust with a hand that it didn't cost you any money to play. See there, it didn't cost you anything, and suddenly we're getting all our chips in with top pair, shit kicker. Any queen beats you here. I mean, there's a lot of king queens, there's a lot of queen jacks in his range. I think you get lucky that he's really that bad. I think the way he played, I think you could even have found a fold if... because there's not... If he was in any way come there, I would have probably checked back and just called his bet. So check there, he'd have bet 800, I'd have called and just try to see a cheap showdown. I don't think even picking up an inside straight draw, I think you're crushed so often when he calls you with it. Fine. Just lucky for you that it was such a bad player, but obviously you knew he was such a bad player. But that's a strange hand actually, this one all in. And aye. I would just say, I would maybe watch that in future, that I don't mind what's going on there. We're making up, oh no, and we're getting rewarded. Let's just go back there. So fold 100% every time. Trick Rick will even tell you that one. You're out of position, you've got the worst hand in the world almost. It's just trouble. What's happening here? What these guys got? Jack 10s, Jack Kings, whatever. If you hit your flop, you're just about to go El Busto with your Jack. Just because you were making up the blind. Spoiled that 150% of the time, Space Cat there. Queen 3 there, King 3 there. Fold, 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 fold. You know why? Okay, but we did. Well, we didn't hit a flop, we... we got ourselves into big, big bother. And then, okay, there's the lesson there to be learned. Oh, the Space Cat's trapping. He's trapping. Oh no, everybody's scared. You got yourself into trouble there, Space Cat. And that's the reason why. Right, now I've lost the plot here now. Everything's just went so mental. I think maybe a bit of frustration's coming in your Space Cat. I would have just let that go after that hand. Got the button. I need a cig here, really, if I smoked. Let me pause this and I don't know if I dislike it, but I do think that he's not got really enough chips for you, Space Cat, to be arsing about with him. He's only got 13 big blinds or something, 14 big blinds, and that's not generally you should be expecting to play for your for at least 3,000 of your chips here in this hand. And I don't really know, with two folks still out behind me, that I really want to be doing that with King Nine. Even with position, your position's not actually going to come into it because it's going to end up that it's just either he's going to come back over the top. It's quite a strange. Again, I don't like the min raise. I don't like it. I think you've got to make it at least 5-5-5 there or something to the thing, but you don't really want to do that because you don't want to induce them to shove on you because you can't really call with King Nine. I think that, and it's only purely because of his stack size that you should be folding that Space Cat. And other times that's an okay raise, but just due to his stack size, I mean, you've not got much room for wiggle there. You can't get it all in. I think you're still whatever after the last hand. I think you have to let that one go, even with the button, even against a donk. As I say, if you double the chips, then I think nothing wrong with it at all. But I think you have to. What was that? And then he's come back with this is just beyond comprehension. This hand. This is just crazy. And then we call, which I don't probably like. He's in. This is just crazy. And there we go. This is probably why I was not. I'm not being results orientated, but see, it's just with his stack size. It's always going to be trouble. So I think you just played yourself a wee bit into trouble there, Space Carbot. But everything else, it's actually quite good, and I don't mind the aggression. But as I say, it's his because of his short stack there. You had to consider. Yeah, I like that. I wouldn't three times the big blind rate. I'm not just been picky here, by the way. I'll be definitely just make it 5-5-5. Try and even induce a reshove with somebody like him. You know what he's like. If you look weak, then you can get so a lot of shite hands, ace sevens, etc. to shove on you. Three times a big blind raise, and that's a wee bit 2004. So I would make I would steer clear of the three times raises. Yeah, made itself. Just a couple of funny wee hands there, really, that generally you. You like that. Check. Oh, checked into bother. That's typical, that's like me. And we can't. Well, we got a wee value bet in there. Don't know what he's going to call away, but I don't. I've seen worse. Right, here, Space Cat. Again. He's quite fine. You know you're going to be having to play against him because he calls with everything. I don't dislike it. I mean, you are playing for stacks with him. You are playing for stacks. And he calls. You have to be betting that 100% of the time. That flop, C betting the flop. And again, it's all just so strange. It's hard to take in. I'm going to get a coffee before the next thing, I think. But hey, I live in the micro world of strangeness, so I should things I get. I will stop it there. What's going on here? Right.